I said, as Akhil said, I mean, even for us, loungewear or athleisure, as we would put it, was not a very significant portion of our offering to the consumers. It's been a smaller portion of our offering. And the trend of athleisure has been picking up over the last year. And slowly and steadily, it's making space into our wardrobes. Outside of India and in more developed nations, athleisure already has about 60% of the wardrobe space of consumers. 60% of the wardrobe consists of athleisure. However, in India, the trend was catching up and slowly. But now, due to the natural pressures and the needs of lockdown, we've all been locked down at home. So we've learned to, you know, stay home. And in that, naturally, what we need is comfort. We've learned to work from home. We've learned to cook. And, you know, we've learned to clean and we've learned to work out, exercise, and, you know, try and spend time by taking care of our health. So naturally, this category is becoming very, very prominent, at least till such time that this need to work from home will remain. And I feel going forward, even for at least another 6 months, it's very difficult to predict that, you know, we may be able to come back to normal working days or working hours. I think working from home is now going to be a way of life. And there is going to be a different era post-COVID as to what we saw pre-COVID. So things are going to change for sure. So comfort will definitely win over style, I think. And naturally, because everyone's worried about job losses, everyone's worried about the economy, people are worried about their future. So fashion splurging, I'm sure, is going to take some kind of beating. But it's very difficult to say as to how much and what will happen because it's too early to predict on basis of any trend. There's none of these, you know, whatever we see now, any sales patterns would be, in my view, enough to establish a trend basis that. So we'll have to take it one step at a time. And India is a very diverse country. There's all kinds of people. I see that on one hand, for casual wear, there may be slack in demand. But on the other end, there are many, many, many people whose wardrobes are full of formal wear. And those people, let's say bankers, have to go to work only for a few hours and are spending more hours at home. Naturally, they don't want to be in their formal wear. So if not everyone would want athleisure, some people would... who don't have jeans in their wardrobe would probably start looking for jeans. People who don't have casual clothes, as many casual clothes in their wardrobe would start looking for casual clothes. So I think there is an opportunity there for casual wear. And it's going to be a while before, you know, we can predict anything. But as far as masks are concerned, I think Bobby rightly said that we need to conserve masks and the, you know, disposable masks are important for people who are, you know, using them at places where they need to dispose them off every time they come across a patient. But whereas for others, it's important that, you know, we use reusable masks. It also helps the environment because today sustainability is going to become more and more important. I think people are, there was a recent survey also that was conducted. And in fact, it was out in Economic Times today that consumers are going to be more and more opting for brands that have sustainable practices. And, you know, sustainable, so the, I mean, earth sustainability consciousness is going to grow up really high. Having a mask that is reusable makes a lot of sense. And yes, of course, we are fashion brands, so we're going to take, they make an opportunity out of this and try to create something which is interesting for people. So I'm sure every brand will have his own expression on the mask.